There is a saying. If a magnet touches a floppy, all data is gone. Well, let's see if that's true. For this experiment, I'll be using 3.5-inch high-density floppy disks, much like these two. I'll also be using a couple of different magnets, starting with this one, an Alnico horseshoe magnet with a 1 kg pull. That means this magnet requires 1 kg of force to pull away from a flat steel surface. To test whether this magnet will affect data on a disk, I'll have to put data on this disk. But first, I'll need to format it. Given the age of these floppies, some have deteriorated, so finding a disk which formats without any bad sectors was quite tricky. But after sorting through various contenders, I found 3 which were suitable. For the purposes of this test, I'll be using 3 disks, one labelled Larry, one Barry, and one Gary. The first disc, Larry, I'll fill with images. This collection of wallpapers from the Windows 98 directory will do just fine. Each one can be previewed and indeed opened. To fully verify the disc's integrity, I'll also run a scan disc which reveals there are now 805,376 bytes in 20 files, leaving 652,288 available. Disk Barry will have something a little different, zip files. Now I don't know about you, but whenever I had corrupted disks in the 90s, it always used to be slap bang in the middle of a zip file. Usually this meant whatever games I'd copied from my mate's computer wouldn't load on mine. So here we have pap.zip and car.zip. Both of these zip files extract perfectly, with pap being Paperboy 2 and car being Grand Prix Circuit. And although it doesn't appreciate running through the Windows 98 command prompt, it still loads. Disk Gary, I'm just going to leave totally blank. So what am I trying to do with these tests? Well, data is stored onto a thin piece of magnetic coated plastic in each floppy. An energized right head can then orientate the north and south poles of tiny, often iron particles embedded on this surface in order to create a readable pattern the computer can interpret. By putting a magnet in close proximity to these particles, we can literally disorientate this pattern and corrupt the data. Legend tells us that this is possible even with quite a weak magnet, or even if you just place your discs too close to your monitor. But I've put my discs through some pretty rough times before, and mostly they've been just fine. Really, I just want to know how much magnetism the data can withstand before it goes bye-bye. So, in a very unscientific manner, I'll just start with Larry.
Hello.
And circle the magnet around the disc without making physical contact. Next, I'll pop the disc back in the drive and see if the data is intact. And yes, indeed, it's all there, everything is readable. Time to move this up a notch. This time, I'll make direct contact with the disc and try again. Surprisingly, again, everything checks out just fine. Okay, so to do this properly, I need to move the magnet around and see if I can misalign those particles. Really get stuck in there. There we go, that should do it. But no, yet again, all the images are present, they are all readable, and even scan disk returns the same results as when I began. The Alnico magnet hasn't even caused a single ounce of commotion. So those memes of someone magnetizing their floppy to a fridge, well, actually the data is probably just fine. I even tried it myself, overnight, with several magnets, and everything was still in place the next day. Apparently we're going to need a stronger magnet. That's where this little neodymium magnet comes in handy. As you can see from the packaging alone, this one packs a punch. No kiddies allowed for this mother. Now, neodymium creates the most powerful magnets per unit volume, and are often referred to as rare earth magnets. This particular one has a pull of 32.2 kilograms, more than enough to disrupt a few particles, I imagine. Bazza, or Barry, is the disc nominated to take the brunt of this one. I thought I'd first do a check with the Alnico magnet, and yes, everything was fine. You can see the difference between these two by measuring how far away each magnet can attract this little bulldog clip. The Alnico needs to be 2 centimeters away, which is just under an inch, whereas Neodymium can spread its attractive force over 6.5 centimeters, or just under 3 inches. So first I'll do the non-touching circling around Barry, which actually again does nothing. The zip files check out and the games are playable. Alright Barry, you've had your fun. How about I just whang this magnet straight onto you and see how you cope with that? Now straight away the floppy drive took longer to read Barry, but on first glance all looks well. However, trying to unzip the files is a different matter. Almost immediately, pap.zip returns a read fault error, and a scan disk returns more errors than you could shake a stick collective at. The saving grace here is that I'm still able to reformat the disk without trouble, so the data may be gone, but the media lives on. Larry suffers a similar fate. Some of the images are fine, but some refuse to load, and once again ScanDisk presents many an error. So Gary, what do we do with you, Gary? Well, I thought I'd give it a good seeing to with this strong magnet, which indeed did upset its formatting quite a bit. But just like its friends, could be reformatted, no problems at all. So, I then decided to get silly. I grabbed a silver marker and rubbed it all over the disc surface to see if it would cause issues, and from the off you could hear there were problems. The drive couldn't even tell it was formatted anymore, and even worse, couldn't reformat it either. At this point I started thinking, what the hell has this got to do with magnets, and what am I doing with my life? But you know, I guess we're left with the following conclusion. Never put strong magnets on your floppy disks, and although weak ones may be okay, it's probably best not to risk it. But under no circumstances whatsoever should you act like a silly twonk and rub permanent marker all over the floppy's surface, damaging both the disks and more likely your floppy drive as well. So that concludes today's lesson. Thank you for watching. If you want more, click here. You can also subscribe and support me if you want to stay really ahead of the crowd, but in any case, have a great evening.